The Department of Homeland Security just changed its internal policy manuals for their USCIS officers, making it more difficult and complicated to get a green card and ultimately US citizenship. Watch this video and I'll tell you all about these changes and what you have to know. USCIS recently updated its internal policy guidelines when it comes to adjustment of status, specifically green cards that are filed inside the United States. The bottom line is, it's gonna get more complicated and confusing to get a green card inside the United States and ultimately getting that citizenship as well. So essentially, if you read this policy manual, they're changing the focus. This administration that is ending very soon is changing the focus, and they're saying that it's more important for them national security and public safety as opposed to family unity, which was the guiding factor of our immigration system for the past 50 years. And with this in mind, the entire process of adjusting status and how USCIS officers are going to look at it is changing. They're going to have a list of factors. We're going to go through these factors in a few minutes. And if you stick to the end, I'm actually going to list those factors in a screenshot on the screen so you can see them. Those are the factors that USCIS officers are going to be going through as they adjudicate adjustment of status cases for green cards inside the United States. Under the old standard, if an officer doesn't see any bad factors, any negative factors, they should exercise their discretion to approve a green card application. Under the new standard, the officer is going to focus on how to deny more applications based on particular criteria. So the purpose is not to find a way to approve more cases. On the contrary, they're looking for ways to deny more green card cases. Once again, another attempt by this administration to shut down immigration in their final weeks. So let's take a look at these factors so you can understand what they're going to be looking for and how to process these adjustment of status in such a way that your cases won't be denied. If you look at the list is divided into positive factors and negative factors. Positive factors, they're meeting the eligibility requirements, and negative factors are not meeting the eligibility requirements. So we've got factors like family and community ties, positive factors, family ties to the United States, and the closeness to the underlying relationship. Negative factors, absence of close family, community, and residence ties. I mean, once again, these are very, very general negative factors. What does it mean that absent family ties? Does the officer have so much discretion right now to make that decision? That's pretty scary. Family and community ties, hardship to the applicant, length of lawful residence in the United States. These are all positive factors. Another factor they're looking is immigration status and history. Positive factors, compliance with immigration laws, approved humanitarian-based immigrant for non-immigrant petitions. What are negative factors? Violation of immigration laws, current or previous instances of fraud, unexpected exclusion, deportation, or removal orders. So once again, if these are negative factors, this gives the officers so much power to say, oh, you know, I think you lied to me, or I think you overstayed, and now because of that, I'll be able to deny your application, as where you know, an overstay could be waived in most adjustment of status cases based on marriage. So we really don't know how far they'll take it, but the fact that we have this list of negative positive factors is a little bit scary, and I'm really worried about how they'll be processing these adjustments in the near future. Other factors, consider business and employment skills, a person has property, investment, money, education. Negative factor, history of unemployment, unauthorized employment, employment for income from illegal activity or sources. Once again, such a big discretion, it just opens the floodgates to so much power that these officers are now going to have that it's really concerning to me. And finally, we have community standing and moral character, respect for the law, honorable service in the Army, compliance with laws, negative moral depravity or criminal tendencies, lack of reformation of character, public safety, failure to meet tax obligations, failure to pay child support. Now we have these factors that were not really a factor before, but all these things could lead to your green card denial if you don't pay your child support, if you're late on your taxes. It just gives the officer so much discretion, and I can see so many people are going to be denied green cards between now and January 20th when we have our new administration. By then, this all is going to be reversed, most likely. They also have a section there that if you're working in the cannabis industry or related somehow to the cannabis industry as an employee or a vendor, that could be also a negative factor on your ability to get a green card, which again, they kind of taken it in a very, very broad spectrum because, you know, there are so many states that legalize that. But the fact that you're actually working in the industry could be a problem for your green card as well. So the bottom line is that this is not a regulation. It's a policy manual. Once the Biden administration is in power, they can easily revoke this in a second. So I think people are just going to wait it out and take their chances. But I don't think that there are going to be too many lawsuits filed on this because of, you know, we literally know that January 20th, all this is going to be changed. So, but it's really important to know that if you're filing right now for your adjustment of status, there's going to be a lot of different factors to consider. And remember that your cases are going to be much more, it's going to be much more complicated to adjudicate your cases under this new guidelines. So hopefully this information was helpful. Leave me a comment, share this video with somebody that may be interested, and subscribe to our channel, and also give us a big like so YouTube will be able to share these videos with more people just like you. If you like this video, make sure you watch these other two videos where we have more information about your cases with USCIS inside the US. And also, if you want to check out our merchandise, we have cool hoodies and t-shirts, all immigration theme related. The link is right here below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.